Maktid Baba Mitzia, page 11, seven lines from the top of the page, we are the Mishnah. The Mishnah dealing with Kinyan Chatzer, a matter of acquisition when it's come to a property, for example, a courtyard. Imagine a situation, a fellow is sitting at his house, he lives in a large place, have a lot of dunams, so over there it's acres, and he's sitting there, he's using a binocular, and he sees in his estate there is a, can be a Hirsch, a Tzvi, Gazette, and he recognizes it. So nowadays, a person can use a gun, and he pull out a gun, uses his binocular, and shoot that animal, just injected some type of drugs to the animal, and as a result, the animal is stuck, the gazette or whatever it is, stuck in his large yard, field. Does that mean that he acquired it by the law of the Dinei Chatzer that we learned in the past several days? Or if someone is a very fast runner and he caught Tzvi while he ran? So the question is, that's the key discussion, מה הגדרת משתמר? What is exactly the definition of חצר המשתמרת? Here we are at the Mishnah. ראה אותן רצין אחר מציאה. If a person sees people, he saw several people running around and they ran after and found ownerless that not belong to anybody. For example, animal. אחר צבי שבו. See a deer, gazette, that it's a cripple. So he's already in his yard. United States, we see it a lot, especially in this season. So unfortunately, the deer cannot run. Or achar gozalot shelo parchu. See a young pigeons that have not yet learned to fly. So they are still in his field. So Rashi said that it's considering a lost, an item, metziah, found. So it's in his field. So he said, v'amar zachta li sadi. So he said, okay, if that's the case, it's my field has affected acquisition of this animal for me. That's the concept that Kinyan Chatzer is all about. Zachtalo. So it's his. So obviously Tosfot said that it's all dependent upon if it's naturally they can fly or not, but Aya Tzvi Ratz Kedarko Shagozlot Mafrichin. If you see a deer that it just running to his usual manner, or young pigeons were flying. ואמר זכתה לי סדי לא אמר לי כלום. And he said, my field has affected acquisition for this animal for me. He has said nothing, as one's courtyard cannot affect acquisition of an item that does not remain there on its own. So Tosfot have a discussion that even if he didn't say he's acquired, because what we learned earlier, that the sages instituted that 400 konot l'adam, that the 4 cubits acquired for a person, even without his intent. And we're going to learn soon, chatzero shel adam kona lo afilu shelo midato, even without his intent. But I would like to share with you a Rambam. The Rambam in Sefer Nezikin, Ilchot Gzela Ba'avedah, chapter 17, and also in Sefer Kinyan, Ilchot Zchiya U'Matana, chapter 4. I'm reading from the Rabbi Steinzer's translation of Koran Gemara. In a case where one sees people attempting to catch an ownerless animal or a bird that are in his field, and he says, my field shall affect acquisition of the animal or bird. If the animal is injured or the bird is too young to fly, such that the owner of the field will be able to catch it, his acquisition is valid, but if he will be unable to catch it, his acquisition is invalid, and that's basically the Shulchan Aruch Hoshen Mishpat in 2:43. So here the Gemara elaborates on the first clause, on the Reisha of the Mishnah. Amar Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel Vehu She'omed Betzad Sadehu. That's an important statement. Rav Yehuda Amar Shmuel says that all of this matter of acquisition that we refer in the Mishnah, it's effective specifically when the owner is standing next to his field at the time of the acquisition, that they acquired the acquisition, so that it has the halachic status of the secure courtyard. So here I would like again to share with you from the Choshen Mishpat, Shulchan Aruch Choshen Mishpat 2:43. If an ownerless item falls into one secure courtyard, the courtyard effects acquisition of it for him even without his knowledge. So that's what we tried to prove at the very early stage. We said that if a person is sitting in his house and see a deer in his field and he uses gun, he shoot the deer just to inject something to his body, and as a result, it means that he owe him medin chatzer based on this. So the Gemara asks a question. V'tikne lesadehu, d'amar Rabbi Yosei b'Rabbi Chanina chatzero shalom kunalu shlo midato. So he said, if that's the case, the field affect acquisition of an animal for him even without him standing next to it. Why? Because here we have the statement of Rabbi Yosei b'Rabbi Chanina that said a person's courtyard affect acquisition of property for him even without his knowledge. So what do you see? Then Yosef explained that Rabbi Yosef Bar Chanina speaks even in a situation that he's not physically standing there, because usually when a person stands next to his courtyard, he can see what he have in his courtyard, and it's not considering shalom midato, meaning a person's courtyard affect acquisition of property for him without his knowledge. So the Baal responds, and they said, no, ha neimile, din azeh, this ruling that Rabbi Yosi Bar Chanina rules, that a person, a courtyard affect acquisition of property for him, even without his knowledge, that apply what? Bachatzer mishtameret. That's a secure courtyard. For example, you have gader, you have fence around the estate. Aval chatzer she'ina mishtameret. For example, if you have unsecure courtyard that is a fenceless around his estate, I Omed betzad sadehu, if the owner is standing next to his field, ein, yes, he is acquired, because by his present, Rashi said, it's secure by him. So the Ritva said that even he's not physically there, he is under his watch. Rashba said, no, he has to be physically there. But the Devot HaMishpat said, the key is how far Yad Mishtamelet, how far he is extending hand. Those who serve in the unit, I met Gabi yesterday. We are 3 decades, right? Serve in the same unit. So at that time, it was a paratrooper base in Sanur. So it was a huge sign, the extended hand of the paratroopers, to show the hands go the entire Middle East. I think you remember that, right? So anyway, so that's the idea. They have the extending hand, the Etz Yosef said, far. Rashash never issued that, because Rashash said that it's only if the Yad is really in his catch, in his control. Like we mentioned in the introduction, you are able to run and catch physically the deer. But anyway, if that's the case, yes. But ilolo. So therefore, Rabbi Yehuda speaks about chatzer she'ena mishtameret, a courtyard that it's not secure. So therefore, he needs to stand next to that yard. So even he just said tikneli sadi, that yard, Tosfot said, quiet for me, he said it's enough. Now there is a Tosfot in Tractate Bava Batra. The sugya over there is oder benichse ager. If someone is digging in the estate that belongs to a convert, but he didn't realize that the convert is no longer among the living. So Tosfot asked from our Gemara, he said, we learned that the person courtyard affect acquisition of property for him even without his knowledge. But anyway, it's a discussion over there in Bava Batra and the Tosfot. So Menat Teimra de Sheina Mishtameret I Omed Betzad Sedeu In Ve'i Lo Lo. So how do you know when you're dealing with unsecure courtyard, if the owner is standing next to his field, you said yes, but meaning that it affects the acquisition of a ownerless item because on his behalf. But if it's not, it does not affect the acquisition of item on his behalf. So now we bring a source in the mitzvah of shichecha. So before we go to that, the great Rav Shtetner wrote a book called Lehorot Natan, and is also the Rav of Strasbourg, asks a similar question. He asks about machshirei telephone, a telephone equipment, or those machines that selling food, drinks, you know, you see it in the public centers, in the malls, etc. So you walk in and you see in the machine money. The money can be many ways. It can be the owner of the machine, can be someone left in the machine. So do you treat it as a chatzer mishtameret, as a secure courtyard, or not? Imagine if there's surveillance there. How you treat it? So there is a general question that those great rabbis ask, how you define chatzer mishtameret? Why? Because we know what we just mentioned from the Shulchan Aruch Choshen Mishpat 268, who said that one acquires an ownerless item that is in his unsecure courtyard only if he's standing next to the courtyard and declares that his courtyard affects acquisition of item for him. But then the Rambam in Ilchot Ma'asrot Anim, chapter 5, brings this important halachot of Shichecha. And you see in Shichecha, and that's the sugya we're going to learn. So before we go to Rambam, let's just introduce the subject. The Torah said in the book of Dvarim, chapter 24, verse 19, Ki tiktzor, if a person cut his sheaves, and v'shachachta omer basadeh, you left in the field, you forgot a sheaf, lo tashuv lekachto, you leave it, and you leave it lager la'yatom elena, to convert, to orphan, to widows. So the Mishnah in Tractate Pe'ah, Mishnah number 7, said that this sheaf en omer na'asa shichecha, under the status of forgotten item, only if both the owner of the field and the laborer, they both walks there, both forget it. So, but if only one of them, either the owner or the laborer, so it's you not leave it for the poor people, the din shechecha is not applicable there. The Tanya Aya Omed Ba'ir Ve'omer, learn the Braita, the landowner was standing in a town and saying, Yodeh ani, שאומר זה שיש לי בשדה פועלים שכחו, לא יהיה שכחה. He says, I know that that my laborer forgot a sheaf that I have in the field, and it shall not consider forgotten sheaf, which must be left for the poor. So then the landowner himself forgot about the sheaf. So they said, יכול לא יהיה שכחה, אז אמרו לו, מה, שכחת עומס בשדה, בשדה ושכחת, ולא בעיר. So only if you return, then you have the din שכחה, but not after you already in a town. So, גמרא סדר, הגוף הקשי, אמרת, יכול לא יהיה שכחה, על מה אבא שכחה, ונשיב לגמרא בשדה ושכחת ולא בעיר. אמר לו, אבא שכחה, אלא לאו אחרי כמה. בשדה השקוח מעיקרו. When you talk about the field, if the sheaf was forgotten at outset, so it's considered forgotten sheaf. So he said, השקוח מעיקרו אבא שכחה. זכור ולבסוף שכוח, אין שכחה, מיתמה כיוון דקאי גבה, he's standing there when the laborer forget it, הבה לחצרו וזכתה לו, לי. אבל בעיר אפילו זכור ולבסוף שכוח אבא שכחה, מיתמה דלת גבי דליזקה לי. ממאי, אבטואן, דילמה גזירת הכתוב ידי בשדה נאבי שכחה או בעיר לא נאבי שכחה, מרקרה לו תשוב לקחתו לרבות שכחת העיר. היי מבעל אליו, אם כן נמקרה לו תיקחנו מי לו תשוב לרבות שכחת העיר. והקטי, no, let me show it to the Rambam. A sheaf is rendered a forgotten sheaf only if the owner of the field, the laborers, and any onlookers are forget about it. If the owner says in advance that he knows that the laborers will forget a certain sheaf, it is not rendered a forgotten sheaf. If the owner is in the town, his declaration has no effect. That's the Rambam. So the Gemara asks from the Mishnah, Ve'akatei, Mibayl Lechdetan, that Mishnah, Tractate Pe'a, Chapter 6. Shelfanav, Ein Shirecha, Shelachara Ve'Shirecha, Shehu Beval Tashuv. So because that's the mitzvah of Bal Tashuv, because Ze HaKlal, that's the rule. Torah said, Kol Shehu Beval Tashuv, Shirecha. כל שאינו בבל תשוב, אינו שכחה. Any sheaf to which the prohibition of you shall not go back applies, so forgotten sheaf, of any sheaf that is prohibition of you shall not go back, does not apply, which is a sheaf that one has yet to reach. Does not assume the status of a forgotten sheaf. So the whole idea of you shall not go back is apparently necessary to teach this halakha, that and it cannot be interpreted as including case where the owner is in a town. That's the meaning. I wrote it in my book Roots Talk about the story of Boaz and Ruth, how he treated it as an exception, not that you have to give her in such amount. Amar Rav Ashi Amar Kra Yihiyeh, which is Lager, Laetom, Velalmana Yihiyeh, Lerabot Shichechat Ha'ir, that include sheaves forgotten while the owner is in the town. So again, the question is, it's applied if he's standing next to that or not. וכן אמר אולה, so the גדולי ישראל, many, many contemporary rabbis ask for this סוגיה, they ask, how do you, איך משווים מציע לשכחה, how do you compare a found item to a forgotten item? שכחה זה הממון שלו, שכחה forgotten item, it's his money. מציעה, it's not his money. So רבי עקיבא איגר דן, imagine you have a homeless. It happened those days, there was a lot of poverty, people who pressed for fun. So you see a fellow is in the street, and he is, have a box, and he's collecting money for himself. He falls asleep. Somebody passed by, and he sees the poor person. You want to give him, and he gave him a large sum of money in his hand. But then the person who gave him regretted. And the person who received it, he woke up. So the question is, to whom this money belongs to? You mean to say that it's considering the poor person who was in a state of sleeping? Or it's a person who gave him? That's the concept of Akiva Yiger, derived from our sugiya, the concept of Chatzer HaMishtamelet or not. Because when the poor person, the homeless person received it, he was asleep. So if he was asleep, but now it's not Chatzer HaMishtamelet because he's already awake. Anyway, that's based on our sugiya, Rabbi Akiva Yiger. וכן אמרו לאבוק שעומד בצד שדהו, where the owner is standing next to his field. וכן אמר אבא בר חנה, והוא שעומד בצד שדהו. So, the question הלכה, derivative from that, the mitzvah of שילוח הקן, the mitzvah when you see the mother bird standing with the babies, the small birds, so you have שלחת, שלחת, you have to let the mother go. Many midrashim, many rabbinic writing, is a sgula leiladim, it's a special, some type of amulet to have children. Yalkut Shimoni said the whole concept of Beren, Akar and Akara, ותבנים תיקח לך. And then the Torah said, כי ייקח איש אישה, that is like a sgula לאישה חדשה. The same, תבנה בית חדש, you build a new house. סגולה לקרן, לפרנסה. The Holy Zohar said that the סגולה of the mitzvah is the Yonah, the dove is crying because they sent away from her nest. And that created רחמי שמיים, the mercy of heaven, because at our Almighty God sent the nation of Israel to Galu, to exile. So that's bring Rachmei Shamayim, the compassion heaven, when you see the dove, it's crying to expedite the Geulah. The problem is, if a person find the ken, the nest, with the mother, the eggs, in his yard, courtyard, and you have eggs there. So you mean to say, he already acquired by what? By the Kinyan Chatzer, by the secure estate. So how will be able to fulfill the mitzvah of Shiluach HaKen? So the Rav Jung Reis was a Ravid, the head of the Best Din of Eidah Haredit in Yerushalayim. He said it's enough for him to say, מספיק שאומר שלא רוצה לקנות, it's enough for him to say that he doesn't want to acquire it. But the great rabbis of Sfarad, גדולי חכמי Sfarad, here we back about 250 years ago, Rabbi Uziel ben Aharon, he wrote a book called Kapei Aharon. And he speak about those Rishonim that hold that it's only midrabanan, only by rabbinic rule, a person can say that Kinyan lo yachul, that the matter of acquisition will not be effective, but not midoraita. So therefore here the Maase Kinyan is not effective. So therefore, the many of the Israel said maybe the solution is that he should declare ownerless of that location, יפקיר את המקום. Or Rav Moshe Feinstein, זכר צדיק לברכה, you see also Rav Meir Eric, have response and other, that he will not be effective. Why? Because he cannot מפקיר מקום שזה מזמן תחת ידו, that it's already for a long time and his ownership. So it means that he's already announced in advance that שלא זכה. So the best is, כי יקרה כנציפו לפניך, that's the זמן המובחר ביותר לפניך, meaning you don't owe it, just לפניך you walk and extemporaneously it happens. Just midrashically speaking, the story, Hasidic story about the Jose of Lublin. So they said that he was very much with himself, he very much מכונס בעצמו. So the Sar Shalom Belz, the great Belz Rebbe, was a very, very young man, not a Rebbe yet, he was walking there. So the Yehudi HaKadosh Pshischa said to him that the Chose, it's very preoccupied with the mitzvah of Shiviti Hashem Negdi Tamid, that I should imagine the Almighty is there all the times. And he said, the person forgets sometimes. So the Sar Shalom of Ber said, we learn in our Mishnah here the difference between La'acharav and Lefanav. So it means he wants to imply Remez. When a person makes Shiviti Hashem all the times, even when he forgot, is not Gam Sheshachach, is not Nikra Shachach. Even if he forgot, is not considered forgot.
So that's the Jose said that he basically calming down. Anyway, we have the Gemara ask a question, the whole concept of unsecure courtyard. Only if the owner stands there. So, Eiti v'Rabbi Abba le'ula, that's a Mishnah, tractate Maaser Sheni, chapter 5, Mishnah number 9. Maaser b'Rabban Gamliel u'zkinim she'u b'hem b'sfina. Here is a story about the Rabban Gamliel and the other elders who travel on the ship. So, he remembered that he's not tied the produce in the field, and he thought that his household thing that it's already used, the Tvo'ami to Kenneth, and therefore they violated his Isur Tevel, that it means that his untied produce they eat. So he wants to have a yesh bara, he wants to announce in advance that he tightened. We explained many times with the 7 year cycle of Shemitah, there is a two different asiriyot, two different tenth that needs to be tightened from the crops. One is Maaser Rishon, the Bamidbar 18 said that that was given to the Levi, and the tenth of that produce was change according to the years. So now, that's the whole Ritva explained, that's the idea of Brera. But Tosfot in Kiddushin 26 explains that he knew that his household not eat the entire food, but he wants to make sure that it's enough food when he returns. He basically make a advance declaration, Tosfot, ask questions that's basically how that Chal Shema Asro, the Pnei Yoshua tried to explain over then, Kiddushin 26, that because he continued, he said, Natun Li Yoshua, that it means that it was given to Yoshua ben Hanania, who is a Levite, and is entitled to receive the first tithe. So it's not just a regular matana. Rashi Erkin 11b said that the moment the Rabban Gamliel announced Kara Shem LeMaaser, that's automatically no longer Isur Tevel, even before it was given to the Levi. But the Rabban Gamliel, based on the Gemara in Pesachim, page 4, he wants to give it to the Levi, Yoshua ben Hananiah, immediately. Why? Because we have the concept, as we said in Pesachim 4, there's Rizim Magdimin LeMitzvot, people who are vigilant, wants to do the mitzvot right away. You see more on that on the Pnei Yoshua tractate Kiddushin, page 26b. Page 11b, Umkumo Muskarlo. So the Choshen Mishpat in Shin Yud Gemel in 3:13 explained to us that when you have a chatzer, a courtyard, all those mitaltalin, movable objects that place in a courtyard, acquired by the renter. So what happened here, Rashi explains that Rabbi Yoshua gave Rabban Gamliel the money for the rent of that location. That's the statement by the end of the Mishnah, v'nitkablu sachar ze mizeh. So since you have to have a special action of acquisition, not money, have to have either kinyan meshicha or chatzer, and it located the tithe in the house of Rabban Gamliel, therefore he have to rent the location, the place of the tithe, rent it to him. So Rabbi Yoshua paid him a token sum to rent the field, which presumably became the equivalent of his courtyard and thereby acquired the tithe. The isu acher shani atid lamud. So here, we explained several times that in addition to regular first tithe, Maaser Rishon, there are others. In a 7 year cycle of the Shemitah, we have also the second tithe, bring it to Yerushalayim, eat it in the state of purity, and you have also different years, such as the third and the 6 years, that they're bringing an indigent, a poor person's tithe, and therefore Rashi explained that that event occurred during the year of Maaser Ani, which is either the third or the sixth year. So that Natun LeAkiva Ben Yosef, it was a Gabay Tzedaka, a charity fund, a treasurer, that was named is Akiva Ben Yosef, and he was also joined the travelers on that boat. Kedeshiz Kebo La'anim, so the Gemara in Kiddushin 27 explains that the Gabay Tzedaka, the people who are in charge for the charity fund, we taking them as the same as Yedei Ha'aniyim, and has the capability to do it for them. And its place is rented to him, so he can acquire the tithe in that manner. So they are basically on a boat. So if you tell me that unsecured courtyard will not be part of purchase, only if the person is standing next to his field, how Rabbi Yeshua and Rabbi Akiva able to purchase that tithe? Tosfot elaborated and said, it cannot be a secure place. Lo haya makom mishtamer. Why? Because it wasn't a separation between the crop of Rabban Gamliel to their own. So it means that if you have an unsecure courtyard, acquire even a person who is not standing next to it. Amar lei ula, respond to Rabbi Abba. And he said, Damei hai merabanan ki dela gamrei in enashe shma'ata. This is a little offensive statement. It's like he said that this Torah scholar, every that person, it looks like a person that never learned or never learned properly, because the Shita Mekubetzet said that acquiring Torah is very different halachic framework than acquiring by something that is hefker, that is ownerless. So here is the continuation of discussion of Rabbi Abba. Ki ata lesura amar lehu, hache amar rabula vehache ot vi tei. Amar lehu, merabanan rabban gamliel metalteleha gav mikarke eknale. So here he acquired in the matter of Kinyan Agav, a movable object together. That's basically we learned in the Mishnah in Tractate Kiddushin, page 26, that a property that doesn't have Achrayut, which is the movable property, Mitaltelim, you can acquire them together with the land. So since they not acquire in a matter of a courtyard, so you don't have to have Chatzer HaMishtameret. Rabbi Zeira Kabla, Rabbi Akiva Lo Kabla. Rabbi Zeira accept that response, and Rabbi Abba not. Amar Rav HaShafir, Rabbi Yehuda Lo Kabla. V'chilu haya lahem sudar liknot heimenu b'chalifin. One of the way to acquire things is a exchange, is called chalifin. It's making in the following matter. Reuven, who is the one who is the makne, one who's transferred the ownership, acquire from Shimon either clothes or chefetz material, and then Shimon can get it back to Reuven, and then he returned to him in exchange. So, Ela, tovat hana'a ena mamon. So, the whole idea of tovat hana'a, it means that you have some benefit of desertion that it's not considering mammon. Soon I'm going to share with you an example. Liknod otah b'chalifin, achana metovat hana mammon, liknod otah olgaber karkas. The Gemara rejected, velohi. Matnot keuna netina aktiva behu. Chalifin derech mikach umimkaru. Metalzim agav karkas, netina alim tahi. That's kinyan agav. Now, what you see here, Chalifin exchange is appear like a matter of exchange, mekach o mimkar. Agav, it's not netina mamash. Now, it was a case that brought to the Shla HaKadosh. It was a very wealthy person that put a separate large fund. The good news was that it was a large amount of money for tzedakah. The bad news was that he decided to whom, tovat hana'a, to whom he distributed the money. So it was the Gabay Tzedakah, those funds that involved with this, that have the access to that account, but the person passed. So one of the Gabay Tzedakah continues to take some money for the tzedakah needs. The heirs, the inheritors, said, no, they want to have the solid and the sole access to that account. So it's brought before the Shlach HaKadosh. So the Shlach HaKadosh said, look, you are Yorshim, you are inheritors of your father, as far as the general property is concerned. When it's come to a discretionary fund, a special charity fund that involved with something that your father have, the privileges involved with that is called Tovot Hana'ad, which means you have the benefit of discretion. That's something that the question, this is not over the Yerusha, this is not perpetuated by matter of hair. So the Ketzot HaChoshen, as well as the Shlach HaKadosh, say that that's important to note. The Nodabi Yehuda, the great Rabbi Landau of Prague, in those days Czechoslovakia, wrote, and he said it is Chidush, but the truth is it's also in the Tosfot Reed. I assume that somehow Nodabi Yehuda did not see the Tosfot Reed. But anyway, he says that when it's come to Truma, we have two separate mitzvot. We have one, is a mitzvah of Hafrashat Truma. Hafrashat Truma, we can do it even less than the pruta values. The second one is called Netinat HaTruma. Netinat HaTruma, it has to be at least pruta. So the discussion is, when it's come to Netina, Betrumot Umasot, if that be the Oraita, is that biblical or it's not biblical? Rashi said that the issue is Marit Ayin, the way that it's appeared. My teacher, the great Rav Shlomo Zalman Auerbach, Zecher Tzadik Livracha, and others, have a big write-up, because today you see a lot of Trumot Masrot that made in Kinyan Chalifin in matter of an exchange, and the question is if it's a Mehat Torah, if it's a biblical, so lo ra'u, it's incongruous, it's inappropriate. But if you tell me that it's not biblical, you can be more lenient. Anyway, Rav Papa Amar Da'at Acheret Makna Otan Shani. Rav Papa said that Rabban Gamliel, which is another mind, transfer the ownership to Rabbi Yoshua and Rabbi Akiva, it is different, and the recipient did not need to stand next to the courtyard. It's important that you see it in the Choshen Mishpat in 243 and 268. I'm just reading the translation from the Koren edition. In a case where an item was given to a person as a gift, and it was passing through his field, even if he could not have caught it, he has acquired it. If it was an animal running to its usual manner or a bird that was flying, and the owner of the field will not have been able to catch it, his field does not effect acquisition of it for him, even though it is a gift. So they said, Umenat Teimra. So from where you state this distinction, Ditnan Ra'otan Ratzim Achar Metziah. So as we said, you see a broken deer. Amar Rabbi Yirmiyah, Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Vehu sheratz achareim umagiam. He chased them, and he is able, he's a runner, he can catch them. By Rabbi Yirmiyah, Matanayach, if it's somebody else and he wants to transfer ownership by giving it as a gift by Kinyan Chatzel, Kabla mine Rabbi Abba Bar Kahana, Aval bishoratz achareim ben magiam. Ma itama? Lam mishum da lachet makna otam shani? Amar l'Rav Shimi l'Rav Papa, Arei get, so they challenge the issue of get. Even soon you see it's different, but in the Da'at Acheret Makna Ota, because that's the idea of the husband give it to the wife, the bill of divorce. V'amar Ula, that's a famous Mishnah we study in Gittin 77b, that if the husband throw to his wife, to her courtyard, the bill of divorce, V'huk she'omedet betzad beita o betzad chatzeira. So it means that Tosfot Rosh and Ramban said that here, when it's come to get, the wife needs to stand the side of her courtyard, even the secure courtyard. Versus when it's come to a gift, the Ramban emphasized, everyone agreed that the secure courtyard, you don't need to have the, when it's gift, the person stand next to the courtyard. So the Gemara responded and said, no, he was different, you know why? Shana get the eitei be'al kocha. When it's a bill of divorce, it's different because it's possible to give to one's wife even against her will, which means that the Ritva said that even she doesn't want to get divorced, he can divorce her by giving it to her. So, again, this is pre-era of the Cherem Ben Gershom, but the concept is the same concept. That acheret, when it's come to gift, is different than a get. So, matkev la Rav Sheshet, totally the hafuch, the reverse way. Matkev la Rav Sheshet b'rei Rav Yidi, v'lav kal b'chomer, u'maged deite bal kocha, היא עומדת בצד ביצה ובצד חסרה, אין, היא לא, מתנה דמדעתי לא כל שכן. So that's the Ritva said. When it's come to give, for sure, the כוח המקנה is more important. Why? You cannot do it against the will of the recipient. You need to stand next to his yard. אל אמר רב אשי, you have to difference between get and a gift, because it's following. And here we are, turning to page 12a. Page 12, as we said, Chatzer itrabai mishum yad. That's what we explain on page 10b, that when it's come to courtyard, is included as a valid means of acquisition due to the fact that it acts as his hand. ולא גרעה משליחות. So the Ritva explained, even the Torah did not merabah מיד, you can derive it from din שליחות. יערב רשע, שיערב מרמשיף, we don't have time. Anyway, גבי גד חובו לה, אין חבים לאדם אלא בפניו, גבי מתנה לזכותו לו, זכין לאדם שלא בפניו. Now, I'd like to conclude with a few points. First, the Chatam Sofer, Ma'arit Al-Ghazi, and others have a discussion. It was a baby boy born, the firstborn, Bechor. So obviously, 30 days later, you need to have Pidyon HaBen. But the problem is, at that place, in that location, it wasn't any Kohen. It was only a minor Kohen, Kohen Katan. So the question is, it was a discussion, can you have Pidyon HaBen with Kohen Katan, with a minor Kohen? Or you can, why? Because in one hand, Katan and Nozoche Midoraita, the minor, cannot acquire, biblically speaking. Because if you come speak to Tumot Masrot, so the Hafrasha, when it's come to tighten the Etzem Hafrasha, it's mitzvah. Now, Pidyon HaBen, by the merely fact that he accepted, it's a mitzvah. And Yeled Katan, when it's come to a minor, Da'at Acheret Maknauto, so the Mordechai and others hold, as we explain here, that Tovat Hana'a, that they have a indirect or direct benefit of the desertion, it's not considering Mammon. So if that's the case, you have here Da'at Acheret Maknauto, Mipidyon HaBen, because it's basically Tovat Hana'a. And that's basically the Ketzot HaChoshen, many other Gdolim discuss, because when you have those different Ma'asrot, as we said earlier, Ma'aser Rishon, Ma'aser Sheni, Ma'aser Ani, all different form of tithes, all of my right in that manner, it's considering Tovat Hana'a. Because when I'm giving a tithe, I can make a decision to whom I'm giving it. Versus when it's come to Pidyon HaBen, as long as you don't give it, it's yours. The moment it's depart from your domain, it's not anymore Tovat Hana'a. It's not like Tumot Masot. You cannot compare the Tumot Masot to Tovat Hana'a. So it's only, so you cannot do Masa Kinyan. So that's basically a discussion, as we said, Chatam Sofer, Ma'arit Al-Ghazi, and others, based on this Mordechai and the Ketzot, Halakha Lema'ase. Also, I'd like to mention the Rambam. The Rambam said, one may not act against the interest of a person unless it is in his presence. For example, a husband may not give his wife a bill of divorce, the get, unless he does so in her presence. If he placed it in her courtyard, when she was not present, the divorce is not valid. That's the Rambam, Hilchot Gerushin, chapter 5. Also, the Rambam said in Hilchot Zechiyah u'Matana, chapter 4, one can act in a person's entrance in his presence. Zachin le'adam shelo befanav. One can transfer ownership of an item that is of benefit to another even without his being present. So therefore, one can acquire a gift on behalf of another, and the item belongs to that person even though it did not reach his hands. If that person does not want to receive the gift, it is not transferred to him against his will. And that's what we said, that's the Rambam, Sefer Kinyan, Hilchot Zechiyah u'Matana, chapter 4. Shabbat.